Hey guys, and welcome to A Policeman's Life. Let me get out of the sun there. I guess you could call this segment Cooking with Crutches. So today I'm going to look at keto bagels. Super simple. It's five ingredients. I'll show you the five ingredients there. Really fast to make. And if you're not even on keto, this is a great recipe. They taste amazing. Personally, I think they, especially fresh out of the oven, they taste just as good as any other bagel. They're healthier for you than bagels. So give it a try. So let's just look at the ingredients. Okay, so for ingredients, we have flour. We have almond flour is going to be our base. We're going to have a cup and a half of almond flour. We have 1 tablespoon of baking powder. We have 2.5 cups of mozzarella cheese already shredded. I shredded it myself instead of buying the stuff. There's a lot of stuff about pre-shredded cheese and the stuff that it contains anyway, so I shredded my own block of mozzarella. 2.5 cups of that, 2 ounces of cream cheese. We have 2 large eggs, and then I don't have them right here. I think I'm going to dig them out. We need some sesame seeds. Okay, so we have the ingredients. I'll just go over them again there one more time. So we have 1.5 cups of almond flour. We have baking powder. We have 2.5 cups of mozzarella cheese. We have 2 ounces of cream cheese and 2 large eggs, and we can top it with sesame seeds at the end. So I'll show you the process of mixing this up. So next we want to preheat the oven. So let's bake, and we want to preheat it to 400. Oh, oops, I did that wrong. Let's do that again. Okay, so we'll let that warm up. Okay, so in a microwave safe bowl, we're gonna mix together the mozzarella cheese. And then the 2 ounces of cream cheese, which is also, if you're doing in grams, it's 56 grams of cream cheese. Let's get that in there. 56, perfect. So you mix that together in a microwave safe bowl. So now, you're gonna take your cheese and your cream cheese, and you're gonna put it in the microwave for 2 minutes. So halfway through cooking this for 2 minutes, we're gonna take it out and stir it all together, try to incorporate it really nice there. This is obviously loads of fun doing on crutches, but you know what, it gives me something new. I'm going crazy just sitting around here, so this is fun. It's gonna taste good later. So we're at a minute 30, so we're gonna go 2 minutes, or sorry, at 1 minute, we're gonna take it out, mix it all up nice and good, put it back in, and then melt it again for another minute. All right, so this is what we have after a minute. We're gonna mix it up and put it back in for a minute. I'm gonna have to put the camera down because it's hard to mix with one hand there. So there's the mixture right out of the microwave. Nice and gooey, all mixed together. Over here, we have the almond flour and the baking powder. I'm gonna take that with my eggs that are hidden over there, and we're gonna mix it all together in this bowl. So let's do that. Okay, so we need to stir in the almond flour and the baking powder, and then my 2 eggs. 1 and 2. We'll mix that up while the cheese is still nice and soft, and make it a little bit of a mess here. It's alright, I should add a bigger bowl. So as you're mixing this up, you want it to form together as like a dough. If it gets a little too, like the cheese gets a little cool and stuff, you can always put it back in just for a little bit to heat it back up, but you don't want to risk cooking the egg too much. So you see it's formed together like a nice dough here. Okay, so now I have the baking sheet, as you can see over here, tin foil with some butter on it. So now I'm gonna take this dough, and what I wanna do, I know the lighting's not the best there, but we're gonna divide it into 6 parts. So So you're just gonna roughly figure out what six parts would be. Maybe put them on the plate here. One. So these are gonna make our six bagels. Cylinder tubes, and form bagels. Okay, so as you can see here, I made 1, 2, 3 bagels. And the other ones I made in shape of kind of like an English muffin. What I'm going to do with those is I'll end up cutting those up and making some mini pizzas out of them. So I got 3 bagels and 2 English muffins. Okay, so now you're going to take the bagels, you put them in the oven. Let's see if I can do this. And you're going to bake for 10 to 14 minutes until they're nice and golden. So we're at 400, and we're gonna bake to 10 to 14 minutes until they're nice and golden. You don't wanna overcook them. So we'll check back soon. All right, it's been about 12 minutes. So let's have a look at those. So as you can see, they're turning out nice and golden brown. So I think I'm gonna take them out. So give me 1 second to do that. Okay, so there you have it. You have the 3 bagels. This one still has a hole in the center of it. And then my English muffins. So they turned out perfect. Okay, so there you have it. Keto bagels. Like I said, you don't have to be doing the keto diet to eat these. They taste amazing. Of course, anything filled with cheese. So there's my bagel. The only thing you would say is sometimes they get a little flat. So when you put them on the tray, kind of fluff them up, and that will probably solve that. And what I've read online sometimes too is that if you have fresh baking powder, that makes them rise a little better. So there they are. Some keto bagels. These are amazing. They're nice and fresh and warm right now. So I'm gonna go and make one up and eat it. And again, you can make this for anything. Like I made English muffins. This is also, it's fathead crust, that's what it is. So you can make your pizzas out of it. So stay tuned for some more keto recipes. So like I said, this episode was brought to you by Cooking on Crutches. Hottie was out, so I don't blame her for not helping me out here. But it was a little harder than I thought. But they turned out really good. I'm really happy with them. So check back again. We'll see you soon.